Okay, now let's go apply the Biot-Savart law to this problem. We want to find dH. dH is I cross R divided by 4 pi magnitude cubed. So let's go back and pick up our pieces. Here is I cross R, right here. Take a good look, and we'll plug that in over on the other side. That's going to be x times 3dv, 3ys, dxs, dys, dzs. Now let's go get the y term. The y term is 3dv times 4 minus xs. Times 4 minus xs dxs dys dzs. Take this whole part, divide it by 4 pi, and let's get r cubed. R is, this is the vector r, so the magnitude of the vector r is 4 minus xs squared plus ys squared plus zs squared, all square rooted. Now it's all square rooted, but it's going to be cubed, so it's to the 3/2. So this is the term that we've got, and let's integrate in order to find h. Now h is going to have two terms here. We can see an x term and we can see a y term. This is going to give us hx in the x direction plus hy in the y direction. And we integrate to find hx. We do another integral, a second integral, in order to find hy. So let's do the hx integral here. That's going to be, just take the part that's in front of the x. That's 3ys dxs dys, dzs, and we're going to do a triple integral, a volume integral, over 4 pi, 4 minus xs squared, plus ys squared, plus zs squared, all to the 3/2. We're going to integrate this, xs equals 0 to 1, ys equals 0 to 1, and zs equals 0 to 1. This is going to give us the x component. So what are we going to be integrating? When we're integrating the xs portion, there's the variable of integration. Here's the ys, and here's the zs. Now suppose we had been finding hy instead. Hy would be the same triple integral, except it would be the term right here in front of the y. It would be 3 times 4 minus xs dxs dys dzs all over 4 pi 4 minus xs squared plus ys squared plus zs squared all to the 3/2. Again, our integrations go from 0 to 1 for all of our variables. So you can see if I wanted to finish solving this equation, I'm going to have to do two separate triple integrals, one for hx and one for hy. You'll learn how to do this in the Biot-Savart law numerically. It's a lot easier in general than doing it by hand.